Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for March the 14th of 2020, well, it is titled Moonrise and Mountain Shadow. So what do we see here? Well, we see a climber in the foreground on the peak of a mountain and looking off into the distance. And what we see is the shadow of that mountain cast over very far on the other side. Now, that's because the sun in this image would have been right behind the photographer. And that is a part of the way the moon's phases work. The moon here was a full moon, and in order for the moon to be fully illuminated, it has to be exactly opposite to the sun in the sky. So the full moon is, in this case, rising right as the sun is setting. So exactly opposite each other. And you'll notice that with the full moon. We'll see that the full moon is very high up in the sky when the sun is not. Full moon is out at night. Whereas the other phases of the moon, you can actually see during the day. In fact, like for example, a crescent phase of the moon is always in the same direction as the sun, very close to the same direction, and is always seen near the sun in the sky, either very close to it right before sunrise or right after sunset. Now, the moon phases are caused by a combination of two things. First of all, the fact that we can only see half of the moon at a time, and the other is the fact that half of the moon is illuminated by the sun all the time. So, always half of the moon is illuminated, and always we see half, but those two do not always line up. And in fact, it is only during a full moon that the half that we see is the half that is illuminated by the sun. During a crescent phase, for example, most of the moon that is illuminated is pointed away from the Earth and we can't see it. So it's a matter of just what portion, how much of the illuminated portion of the moon that we can see at any given time. And that's the cycle that it goes through, which are the phases which occur over the course of a month, taking about 29.5 days. So if this is a full moon, then 29.5 days later, about a month later, we would get another full moon. And that's actually where our month comes from, was from the cycle of the moon, which is just about 30 days, which is the typical length of one of our months. So here we get to see that moon as well as the shadow of the mountain peak off to its right, with the sun not visible in this image, but would have been directly behind us. As we're looking at this, the sun would have been setting right behind us, and the moon would have just been rising and looking very red because we're looking at it through the atmosphere. When we look very low on the atmosphere, we're looking very through a lot of atmosphere, especially close to the horizon, and that causes the moon to look distorted and to also look very red. And you'll notice that if you watch the moon set or the moon rise. And similarly, you can get similar things with the sun. And that is all just an atmospheric effect caused by the Earth's atmosphere. Were there no atmosphere on the Earth, you would just watch the moon rise and it would look just like any other time you looked at the moon. Same for the sun. You would not see all of those distortions which are caused by the Earth's atmosphere. So that was our picture of the day for March the 14th of 2020. It was titled Moonrise and Mountain Shadow. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be Comet Blizzard. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.